It's from an American band called Earth. It's an album that they had, but it's also a biblical reference to a passage about Samson. And it was used by an American novelist named Cormac McCarthy in a novel called Blood Meridian. So it's one reference that connects a lot of different points, which is really similar to the way all the artwork is, that it's an upside down American flag, for instance, over there. It's also the corporate logo for a recording label called American Recordings. It's run by Rick Rubin. They used to have Slayer and Johnny Cash. It's also a symbol of America in distress. So all these things, they're not fixed points. You know, it's like looking at a map. There's a coordinate on the map, and that coordinate tells you this is where you are. None of these things work like that. They tell you you're in five places simultaneously, if that makes any sense. So, for instance, that's that X drawing right there. That's a California band called X. It's the album cover for an album called Los Angeles, but there's also a Los Angeles artist named Chris Burden, who did a similar kind of sculpture. This is burning form, which just in happenstance is very evocative of that album cover. So all these things are like one connects to the other, connects to the other, connects to the other. It's I am a product of it. I am deeply critical of it because it is hard not to be, because there are a lot of horrible things connected to it. But at the same time, pretending that I'm anywhere outside of it would be utterly insincere. So I am a product of it, I'm a reflection of it, I am deeply critical of it. All those things can, just like coordinates on a map, can exist simultaneously. So one thing can be this, can be this, can be this. I can be absolutely appalled, disgusted by a lot of things about my country, at the same time be a representative, therefore, of it. For me, the area that I'm in, which is upstate New York, there are a lot of salt mines and salt production, but also the American artist Robert Smithson, who in the 1960s, one of the people sort of invented earth art, famously he used salt as a material a lot, and it's kind of a signature material. You think salt, you think Robert Smithson. The first time he used salt was when he was doing an exhibition that was in Ithaca, where I'm from. So he used the salt from my area. So in the similar way that, you know, Charleroi has this history of industry that's now gone, the area that I'm from has, not similar, but there's industry that's no longer there. So it's, you're able to locate a landscape, biography, or history, the more evocative associations with what is salt, like Lot's wife and all these kind of things. So again, it's not one fixed meaning. It's something that material, salt, connects all these different things, which is why I'm interested in it. Specifically, 60s American post-minimalism, Robert Smithson, Ithaca, New York, ex-industrial areas, etc., etc. The landscape is defined by slag piles. You know, the soils, the remains, defines the physical landscape of this area.